Welcome to a new test and teardown video. Oops, I'm supposed not to drop this one. That was close. That was funny. Oh man. So this is a FET voltmeter. It's made by a Danish radio amateur, OZ7HX. And it's really beautifully made. With the name in here as well. I think those are those litra set rubber, rub the text on, and then you can actually see the reflections here. That's, he's been adding some varnish on the top to secure the text, so that is really nice. But what is this? So this white glittering, can you see what I'm saying here? And it is also up here, so I kind of don't dare to turn this on before I've inspected this a little bit deeper. But here's another funny thing. There's a sticker on the back, call sign in 1975. It was also written here, 220 volt AC, and then look at that, three tiny little labels with some dates. I think those are calibrated plus minus 1% in 1980, 78, and I can't pick up the first one. That's quite cool, isn't it? So somebody really spent a lot of time making a really nice voltmeter, and I kind of like this color here. This reminds me of a electronic brand using this color, but I think this is probably salt water. So this was somewhere with a lot of salt water. This is something I want to test, so maybe I can find a method of testing that. So here is my idea. Take a little bit of water, and let's first just try and take one of these, dip it into the water, and then put it here on the table. Let's take the ohmmeter and put it so it's 300 or 400 kilo ohms, and the distance is about 3 millimeters. Okay. So let's take the other end and see if we can take a little bit of this dibbity dibbity dip. If this is salt, it should be fairly conducting, right? So this is what we have. Kilo ohms. So yes, this stuff is salt. So this is not good. So I have to open this and clean it up. And we are now inside. Oh my gosh, this looks bad in this angle. How is this possible? And look in here. It's also salt inside, but actually, the power supply PCB is really, really nice and clean. So that is good. Then we got, that is the range selector switch with all the resistors and all that kind of goodies. And I mean, you may think this looks a little bit funny with all the resistors hanging and dangling all over the place, and I must agree that it is a little bit funny, but this is definitely an okay way to do it. I mean, this is not going on a spaceship to Mars or anything. This is just standing on a table, and you just wanted to be able to adjust around on these resistors until everything is perfectly fine. So I can't wait to see if that is still working. And here's the amplifier board. Look at all those dual MOSFETs and sexy parts here. So that is the input in a shielded cable, even going to that little amplifier board here. And is it possible to see what that is? I don't know if I can see that. BCY, so la 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 la. I'll have to Google that a little bit. Yeah, but first of all, I want to clean it up. Yeah, look at that. The hole to the meter. Yeah, man, I hate to make those big, big holes in a thick aluminium plate like that. It's, and then you put in the meter. Nobody can see how beautiful you made the hole. So why bother making it really beautiful? This is perfectly fine. The big task is about making those four holes so the meter is nice and straight. I mean, that is accomplished. Definitely, it's exactly where it's supposed to be. So that is a little bit impressive, because that is not so easy, actually. But now I will clean up. Oh my gosh, that was a lot of cleaning here with water and paper, and I had to take out the display, the meter, of course. Clean the glass. It was like all over the place and inside everything here. So now I'll try and dry away all the water, and hopefully I didn't get it too. No, I didn't get any water into anything. Fun thing is here, it's still being kind of salty looking. Yeah. That's how it is. Not that easy, huh? So that was a nice cleaning job. Look at that, nice and beautiful again. Yeah, so now I'm ready to power it up and see if it works. About those field effect transistors, I've been doing a little bit of research, and that top one here, that is a dual JFET called DN349. It is, of course, absolutely obsolete and impossible to find and get anywhere. So that is definitely interesting. And then the other one here is a BCY88, and that is a dual matched NPN. And if I'm not mistaken, you can see the two go here, and then we got, there's some resistors that go here and all that kind of stuff. I think they are connected together in like a discrete build op amp kind of configuration. And then you adjust either the gain or something like that on that one. Direct connected to the meter, I think. Why don't we see anything in those two holes? Okay, we got the wires underneath, and it goes, I don't know where, somewhere. Oh, there's actually a really neat feature of this one. See, this is a micro switch made to turn on and off the mains. And look at that. I love it. This is nice. I mean, no more holes, no more extra switches and stuff. That is absolutely cool. I can even hear that it's still working. Of course, this fuse holder here is probably not the coolest. Oh, look at that. It is homemade. Just soldered to some, what the heck is that? Yeah, okay. But if it works, then let it work. That is nice. Yeah, let's see if it works, right? I think it's too much talk and too little action here. Let's plug that in. Nothing bad happened. .9 watts. Oh, and we even got a little light in there on, And how about this one?
Ooh.
Oh, wow, that is nice. It's a perfect feeling. So I put it for 0, and this is 10 volts. And here we go with 6 volts. Let's see what happens. What the heck, man? I did not expect it to be that accurate. Of course, if we are in the middle of the screen, and let's turn it off again here, and let's see. We actually need to have it. Now we go for the money shot here. I mean, it is accurate, really, really accurate. So that is 6. Let's go for 7. 8. Okay, so there's a little gain thing here. 9 and 10. But come on. This thing is very, very old. So, oh, 6. No, 6 is not the same place. How is that possible? Hello. Ah, so that's drifting. Okay, that's terrible. So you have to put it back there. And here's your 6. Okay, and I know exactly why that is the case. You want to know why? Look at that. Here's the power supply. And all we got, that will be 4 diodes and some capacitors. And then the capacitor of the big one here. See, that is a Zener diode. Series resistors, resistor that handle the current into the Zener. Then this center point, the Zener voltage, go to this NPN transistor. And then the output of the NPN, this is just an emitter follower. Then the emitter goes to that capacitor here, and this is our DC output. So this is your power supply for this. And obviously when this Zener gets warm, the voltage changes, and also there's no feedback. I mean, making such a beautiful dual JFET and dual matched NPN kind of amplifier is like really, really sexy. Why not add one more transistor to measure the output and then handle the, I mean, it's not that complicated to make this if you really insist on not using ICs or anything like that. And I can even show you. Look at that. So that's the signal getting warm. Or maybe we should even go into a little macro picture here. Probably make a nice picture. Yes, see? A nice and shiny signal diode. And that red glowing resistor there is like 40 Celsius. That one here, that is the resistor that handles the power on LED. Oh, that is so nice. But anyway, that is a nice field effect voltmeter. I kind of like it. I want to make a funny little measurement, because meters with field effect transistors and stuff like that, that is some, they're known for their insane high input impedance. So how about we try and see if this is still the fact. Is it really doing that, right? So here's our 6 volts. Okay. Let's just say that that is 6 volts. So let's try something first. Here's our 6 volts again. Okay, good. So this is 1 mega ohm. Ooh, so that, why are we having this kind of, oh, that is the ground wire that is not having a good contact. So here you go. Now it's 5.5. You know what I want to do here, huh? So if I'm not mistaken, this is 10 megohm. And now we got exactly 50% readout. So that means my input impedance is 10 megohm. So that is not bad. That is really nice. That is the same as stuff like this will have, right? And that means I can use high voltage probes and all sorts of stuff and stick it in here. That's actually a really cool thing. There's actually only one thing to figure out here. That is, of course, the distance between the bananas that is not following a standard. The standard distance. That is annoying. Oh, I always hate stuff that doesn't do that, because now we got 10 mega ohms of input, right? See, if you follow the distance, so that means you can use stuff like this, then you can also interface to all sorts of standard equipment, current sensing, voltage, high voltage probes, and yada yada whatever. So anyway, I wanted to end this video now. It's already way too long, but thank you very much for watching, and that was another really cool homebrew product that still works. 1975. Ha ha.